So you came. I have to admit, I didn't expect that.
Adila. So it's true. What is this? Why am I here? And what did you do to that man?
Still as forgetful as you were back then, aren't you, brother? To the circle! Now!
What?
To the circle?
What in blazes? I told you to come alone. What is this, Jespar? Some
you don't
kind of
see
ambush?
Me.
How could you, dammit? How
I'm
could
I'm unseen.
You?
No, 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 Adila,
screw
you're taking
you.
This the wrong way.
Whoa. The hell?
Your turn.
What'd you do to him? Whoa. Oof. Ow. Well, got the black stone. Ooh, that filled me up completely. And once we would turn this one to arc, but where's... Wait. Is he not really dead? Because I can't actually search him. Jespar! Valenzio Duran. Who the hell is that? Valenzio Duran. Jespar, no. I did find all these books of healing. Jespar. I had this fire extinguisher type spell. I don't see it now. This I should use more often, or actually at all. Divine Shield, increase your armor rating by 70. That's gotta help. Heals the caster. My friend. I wasn't spotted though. She told him to stand on the circle. And who is this guy? Valenzio. Maybe he's okay, maybe he'll get up. Because I can't search him. How do I get out of here? Please get up. Oh! Oh my god. Is he the veiled woman?
Oh. How unexpectedly death calls us to him. It is bitter, is it not? Unfair.
You scared the crap out of me. And you're still scaring me. You're the one who killed Sirius on the ship.
You are angry because you blame me for the death of your friend. But I only did what had to be done.
What had to be done? You almost killed me.
You are furious about the danger I brought upon you.
But well, yeah.
What would have happened if I hadn't been there in that ship? Let us dare a glimpse, Prophetess. A glimpse into the reality which you prefer to this one. Three hours after your brawl, Captain Rosio's ship enters the harbor of Ark. You wait until the noise falls silent, and together with your friend, you sneak onto the deck. And you almost make it. A few arm's lengths from the safety of the dock, a sailor named Rajik takes note of your presence. There is no need for an explanation as to who you are. And maybe on a normal day, Rajik would have let you run. But not today. For years, he has been eagerly awaiting his promotion to become a petty officer of the 8th class. And yet today, it was announced that his loathed rival had won it instead of him. And how angry he is. How furious.
Oh.
And who knows? Maybe it is not too late. What better way to impress the captain than to be the one who discovers two stowaways who have eaten the crew's bread for a month?
So if that had not happened...
It ends quickly. One sword for your neck, the other one for your friends. And no one to grant you a second life this time.
But she didn't slice my neck.
That is not what happened. The first beat of a wing. And where are you now? You have abilities others wouldn't even dare to dream of. You can hear the echo of the future. And you will make decisions whose extent even you will barely understand.
No doubt on that.
So tell me, Prophetess. Isn't that a fate preferable to the other?
You're just guessing. There's no way you could know what would have happened. But inside, I'm like, yeah, she knows everything somehow.
You accuse me of lying. And your doubts are justified. For I cannot see the future.
Oh, you can't.
However, there is no need for that. All that is required is a glimpse beyond the surface. And suddenly it becomes clear that we are nothing but a sea of endless possibilities. And if one listens long enough, the shapeless takes on form, and the unfathomable becomes tangible.
Oh, okay. I saw what you did in Castle Dalgalar. That was you. You killed Kalia's father, and you abandoned her in that village. Oh, that's an evil laugh.
You claim that I took part in the death of the grieving man. But was that really me, I wonder? Or only a splinter of what I really am?
A splinter?
I have many forms, Prophetess. And I am everywhere, even when you can't see me. But yes... I paved the girl's way, just as I paved yours. Some things have to happen, so that consistency may persist.
Consistency? So you're saying that you can see into other eventualities, into parallel realities?
You ask if I can see more than just this branch. And the answer is yes, I can. But considering what I am, that is not much of a feat.
What you are? And what exactly are you?
You wonder what I am. Yet your question should not be what, but where. And the answer to this is everywhere. What you see right now is merely a splinter.
Well, no, I want to know who you are, what you are. How can you be in all realities? How did that even happen? If you can see into other realities, so the high ones and the cycle exist there as well?
You want to know if what threatens you threatens other realities too.
Yes.
And yes, it does. The cycle is a logical consequence, born from the right circumstances. And these are not limited to your branch.
Well, I have a vested interest in my branch, and I don't want to see it destroyed by the High Ones. Are you a High One?
You wonder whether I belong to those whom you fight. But no, I do not. The High Ones, humanity, the emissaries, these are but elements of the game.
The game?
I am more than that.
So what? Are you just here to confuse me?
You think my intention is to disconcert you, but you're wrong. I am here because you think it was I who took someone you cared for. And although you err, I do not like being seen as a destroyer. Which is why I will wipe away my debt, which was never there to begin with. Step back.
How can you wipe away a debt which is never there to begin with? Answer me! Are you gonna bring him back? If you bring him back, I'll leave you alone. At least for a while. Oh, he's rising like a lost one.
Farewell, prophetess. Maybe we will meet again. Maybe not.
Tending to think we will. Jespar is right there. So mysterious. My suspicion was right. Jespar's sister, Adila Dalvaric, was responsible for the murders. She discovered the stone for herself and saw it as some sort of calling to continue her father's, Damian Dalvaric's, legacy through killing criminals in gruesome ways. The meeting of Jespar and his sister escalated, and Adila killed him. However, before I could leave the cave after defeating her, the veiled woman appeared. She spoke of a non-existent debt and revived Jespar. Well, because she thinks that she owes me something, but yet she doesn't. Jespar?
That's my name.
Glad you know it.
But Adila?
Dead.
What happened?
She attacked you, and I had to do something about it. I'm sorry.
But I only remember a flash of fire and then darkness.
Well, that was her.
Everything's so blurry.
Jespar, I don't quite know how to say this, but for a little while you were actually dead.
What?
You heard me. Well, the veiled woman I told you about, the one whom we met on the ship, she brought you back somehow, which I don't understand myself.
But... Okay, I'm sorry, but this is all just a little too much. Please, just give me some time with my sister, all right? Go back to Ark with that bloody stone. Go anywhere, but please, just leave me alone.
All our friends are, like, sick of us. We want us to leave them alone. Oh, sorry. I reduced her to ectoplasm. Somehow that makes it even worse. She gave me all my health back. That was the most I've ever seen. You scared the crap out of me, that lady. I don't know if I want to hang around in Duneville. Do I have anything else to do here? You know, if I go back to the city, I might be able to buy some more enchanting books there. I do have quite a bit of pennies. City. I think I want to wait before actually exploring this area some more. I mean, I can pretty much handle everything except for those bone crusher, bone splitter things. Those are tough. I'm gonna just have him around. What are these structures? A banana palm? I got a banana. Oh. Elementalism expert. I did not notice these things when I was here the last time. Ooh. Am I supposed to jump from one to the other? Because I don't see a way up to the other one. Ooh. Okay, I'm stuck back here. I don't think there's anything else up there, actually. Oh, here as well. Hmm. Ah, damn it. I don't see anything up there. Well, I want to find a way up to one of them. Ah! I almost got it. Ah, yes. Oh, there's a door there? There's a door there as well. Oh, brother. What? Okay. Well, that's weird. All right. All right, never mind then. Past the Dalvarak Estate. Back through here, right? Enchanting or entropy books. I only need 5 more entropy and then I'm maxed out on entropy. I'm making sure I'm headed the right way, yes. Historically had a hard time finding the entrance to the city. Oh wow. There's some big cave over there. Up here, I think? Maybe? Or not. That's where I fell and almost died, yet got inside the city. I think that does not go to the city. I think we're okay over here, we just need to find the entrance. So it's not there. What does that mean? Not yet, we have to go further this way. Further. Apparently that is the way. We're very close to it. Kind of doubtful, but is that you making that sound, Marius? Yep, I am having a hard time finding my way into the city. I'm past it now. Maybe I should put on Divine Shield and drop down again. I don't know. There's something on top of that? Mm. I can't climb that. Excuse me. This? By the wagon. Maybe? No? I don't get it. I don't know why I can never find my way in. Maybe it's coming from another direction entirely. Will armor help you? Last time I dropped on something, luckily. That looks like a shorter way down, doesn't it? I don't want to be killing the guys from up there. I think it's around the other way, actually. Divine Shield. 4 minutes. That's pretty good. Hi. It's not the way in. This is people's apartment, you know. Or house. To the Entropist, it's a hop, skip, and a jump. Wow, horrible frame rate.
Pity.
Ew.
Evening.
Move along.
Never.
You're from the surface, aren't you?
Yep.
They say that Taylor Aranthiel came back.
He did.
Let's hope he knows who rules this place as well as the Trichessa did.
Yeah, I do. I rule this place. Just don't know it yet.
Evening.
That it is. Ew. He's up there, but we kind of have to jump through hoops just to get to him. Ah. Thank you very much. Yeah, it's over there we want to be.
Potatoes gone.
Oh, jeez. Oh, you're down here. Okay, good.
Fair enough. Maybe there's a trick or two I could show you. But trust me, they don't come cheap.